A family favourite, but health experts are now warning that fish and chips could actually make you more susceptible to catching the flu. Dr. Penny Adams joins us now with more on this from Sydney. Penny, good morning to you. What's behind this warning?
Okay, Deb, this is research that's come out of Michigan State University, their toxicology department, and they've been researching a food additive that's a preservative. It's found in cooking oils and frozen meat and fish. It's called TBHQ, and this food additive is thought to interfere with the immune response. In particular, they were testing it to the influenza virus, and not just the immune response, but also the immune memory to that virus. But let's drill down on this a little bit. First of all, this research has been done in mice, not in humans yet, and they had to guess or try and estimate the equivalent amount of this chemical that would be in an average human diet and then expose mice to that. So it's the research hasn't been done in humans, and you know, there's a varying amount, excuse me, of how much of this chemical that the average human has in their diet. So my advice on this would be, in terms of, particularly in terms of influenza, watch this space. It hasn't been tested in humans. Have your flu shot. Definitely have your flu shot. And the thing is, I have a healthy diet that's based largely on plants and some meat and fish. And if you love your fish and chips, then you can still have your fish and chips. But I wouldn't advise that you have fish and chips for breakfast, lunch and dinner.
Which would be your advice anyway, and the poor old mice, they're copping it again.
I know.
But does it apply, Penny, to all food that is cooked in this type of oil, or is it just specifically fish and chips?
Well, it's the chemical, it's a preservative, so it stops these foods going off, and they add it to cooking oil to obviously increase the lifespan of the cooking oil, but they didn't specify in the article I read exactly which oil, cooking oils it was. But if you assume it's in all cooking oils, I think fried food all the time is not a good idea anyway. So if you stick to your healthy, you know, balanced diet, lots of fresh fruit and veg and some meat and fish, and don't have a concentration of fried foods, I don't think it's going to be a problem. And bear in mind that this research, it has been done in the lab, in mice, and it hasn't been shown yet in humans. And also bear in mind, we're coming up for flu season, so get your flu shot anyway.
Mm. Yeah, because now is the time to get it, isn't it? You gave us our flu shot in studio the other day, but now's the time. Get to your GP, get to your pharmacy.
And I think sometimes when this research comes out and it's been done in the lab and it hasn't been extrapolated into humans, and they sort of theorise about what might happen in humans, it can be quite frightening for people. And, I mean, I love fish and chips, but, yeah, I just have it as a treat every now and then, not three meals a day. So I think it's about having your healthy, balanced diet, getting your flu shot, looking at research as it comes through, but trying to get it in context.
Fantastic. Good advice as always, Penny. Thank you.